The original man is actually the black man,
Mm-hmm.
the maker, the owner, the creator, the planet Earth, father, civilization, god of the
God of
universe.
the universe.
And like I said, God only means man. So I want to make sure I quoted that degree, because like God only means man, so anybody can be, you know, one of responsibility, because man is intelligence. You know, you utilize your intelligence to take care of your responsibilities.
New math is whipping motherfuckers' ass. You want to know how to rhyme? You better learn how to add. It's mathematics.
Mighty most deaf.
It's simple mathematics. Check it out. I'll revolve around science.
What are we talking about here?
Peace, peace, peace. It's Rakim with Wiser Dome TV. Today I have a very special guest, 5%er, intelligent brother, you know what I'm saying? His wisdom and understanding is always good, you know what I'm saying? My brother, Supreme Justice of Law from God Cities, from Virginia, you know what I'm saying? I appreciate you for coming through, God.
Yeah, most honored, God. I'm glad to have be up here with you, building with the gods and building with the family.
Yeah, you know? No doubt, God. How is everything, God? You doing all right?
Yeah, everything's peace, you know, on the knowledge wisdom day, you know, saying manifest understanding, everything's, you know, just as order as it need to be right now. You know what I'm saying? I'm actually, you know, in a pretty good mood right now.
Yeah, same here, God. Same here, God. Definitely glad to have you on, G. And so, you know, let's take it from the beginning. You know, we always do the knowledge first. What led you on your path to knowledge itself?
Well, you know, basically it was through it was hip hop first, which is music. You know, it was something that, you know, I would hear, you know, remnants here and there throughout the music. I never knew what it was until one day, you know what I mean, my sister, she introduced me to a brother that she was dealing with at the time, you know, who she thought was a Muslim actually. Mm-hmm. But when I had to build it with him, after actually getting to know him, couldn't find he was a 5%er, you know, but I knew about that because one night we was, you know, reading the Source magazine, you know, this is like 98, Source magazine in 98, you know, I can't remember exactly what issue it was, but Nas was on the front cover. And within that magazine had an article on Wu-Tang. You know, by that time, Wu-Tang was hot, you know, saying that Wu-Tang Forever had just dropped and everything, you know, and I had a question. I was like, yeah, I like him and all that, but my only problem is, like, why they call themselves the gods? Because I came from a Christian background. So saying, of course, they call themselves God was blasphemy.
Right.
Blasphemous. And so he's like, yeah, well, because they are. You know, and I'm like, you know what, the gods of hip-hop or something? He was like, nah, they're the gods for real. I said, well, how do you know all this or whatever? He says, because I'm one of them. He's going to find he's a children of God himself. He's a 5%er. So I'm like, oh, snap. So he started breaking it all down to me. And God, like, that whole night, We was at my mother's dinner table for like 3 hours straight. He was just giving it to me. He was dropping on me. I went to bed that night with my mind just blown by what I was hearing. You see what I'm saying? And one of the things he mentioned is funny because it's mathematics and knowledge, wisdom, manifest understanding. One of the lines he spit to help me understand mathematics as a whole was from the Bobby Digital album, the Bobby Digital record with Timbo King. He spits, I said, knowledge is the foundation when I move in the L's formation against Hell's Nation. And when he said that, he was talking about 1, 2, and 3. Knowledge was understanding. I said, whoa. You know, it threw me. I was like, wow. You know, it kept it so simple. And it was different, like lessons, like who's the original man, and so on and so forth, that that was mentioned in these rhymes. So, and then like a couple of days later, I decided to hit him up by that book of life. He said, well, I can't do my book of life, but I can start building some mathematics. It's okay. And from that point on, the rest is history.
Indeed. Like, I think that's dope because, you know, it just goes to show and prove that art can open doors for us to have a greater understanding on certain things whenever it's done right. You know what I'm saying? Like to be able to, like whether it's music, whether it's poetry, whether it's a movie, you know what I'm saying? Like whenever you're introduced to certain concepts within art, it can kind of, you know what I'm saying? Like it will resonate with you and therefore allow you to not be closed-minded whenever information comes to you. You know what I mean? Because a lot of people, you know, hearing the fact that, yo, the black man is God, the black woman is earth, like, especially coming from a Christian background, you know, that is, if you've never heard that before, a lot of people will you know, call that blasphemy or even be strongly opposed to even calling a man God. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, indeed. Well, at the end of the day, God only means man. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Mm. You know, that's what a lot of us learn in this nation, in this culture. You know, God only means man at the end of the day. You know, especially about responsibility. And so a lot of individuals who will have a hard time grasping that because of the background they come from. See, when I said what I said about the question about them being the gods, that was me understanding how, for me as and my personality, is I'm very inquiring individual. You see what I'm saying? So I was learning about myself right at that moment by asking that question.
Right,
you see
right.
What I'm saying? Like so I want to know why they say these things. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You know, because I'm a fan, and it's like, you know, as a fan, you want to know more about the people that you rock with.
Right, right. True indeed. As far mm-hmm. as what it means to be God and the responsibility that comes with that, like, what does that mean to you? Because I know I've heard a lot of times where, you know, people will say things like, if you God, you know, walk through that wall or you know what I'm saying? Just mm-hmm. like, you know, they'll attach mystery God concepts to men,
yes.
You know what I'm saying? But when it comes to being God and the responsibility that comes with it, like what does that mean to you?
Well, we know that the original man is Asian, the black man, mm-hmm. the maker, the owner, the creator, the planet Earth, father, civilization, God of the universe.
God of the universe.
And like I said, God only means man. So I want to make sure I quoted that degree because mm-hmm. like God only means man. So anybody can be, you know, one of responsibility. Because man is intelligence. You know, you utilize your intelligence to take care of your responsibilities.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? The reality is that the supreme being, the most high in existence, is the God of the universe, who is the original man, Asia, the black man. Now, the responsibility is like right in that degree, the maker and the owner. Mm. You see what I'm saying? Of course, we are responsible for self.
Right.
You gotta take care of yourself pretty much. You know, it's self-respect. Mm. You know, self-respect at the end of the day. And just knowing your duty as God and as a man, you know,
right.
You say you're the father, you say you're a husband, you say you're a son, a brother. Each one of these titles have responsibility to them.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? And, you know, not everybody's going to be able to hold responsibility on that level. So mm-hmm. in other words, not everybody's going to have that reality of being God because they're going to depend on something else to, you know, do for them, to get responsibilities for them. And when it comes to being God, God don't depend on nobody.
Right.
See what I'm saying? So it's all about, you know, what it means to me is that, you know, just being somebody that is responsible, responding to your ability. Mm. Your abilities, you know, are supreme.
Right. Most definitely. I 100% agree. You know, it's whenever you say you God, you know, people should be able to see that within how you move, with the things that you take care of, your word being bond and just, you know, because anybody could say it, you know what I'm saying? Like anybody could quote the degree, but you know, we have, whenever we know and we take on the responsibility of being God, then we know, like you said, there's nobody coming to save us. And so what you gonna do? You gonna set up home and wait for that mystery God to bring you food, or you gonna go out there and work and do what you gotta do? Start a business or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Do what you got to do to eat, you know what I mean? And putting that responsibility on self, I think, you know, for those who accept it, makes us better men, you know what I'm saying?
Indeed. You know, and like, we accept it because it's in our nature to do such, you know what I'm saying? Mm. You know, we're not, you know, again, not depend on anybody to do for us, you know what I'm saying? You know, knowledge of self is about doing for self. Knowledge of self is knowing who you are and not being content with who you are.
Mm.
You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you're just content with who you are, then you're not really growing and developing, you're not elevating. You know, God is always elevating. You know what I'm saying? So
what you think make brothers and sisters content with who and where they are? Like, where you think that come from?
Well, honestly, you know, when it comes down to being the God of Earth, you know, honestly, it's the title itself. Because again, like we were saying earlier, the mystery God concept is still attached to some, you know, even with knowledge itself, and them saying they're the true living God or whatnot, they still haven't gotten rid of that religious way of thinking.
Yeah.
You know, so it's like, you know, the entitlement is there. It's like, oh, I'm God. Like, you know, I can do whatever and still be God. It's like, yeah, but at the same time, responsibility is something that you need to adhere to. Mm-hmm. Because I think about culture is one's way of life. Mm-hmm. And being living free within the realm of reality, knowing that you can live amongst anybody, any place, anything, or have any idea you want and manifest it, doesn't necessarily mean it's going to come back to you in the way you brought it out. Because there's such thing as called as what? Justice.
Yeah, justice.
So you got freedom
for your ways and actions.
Indeed, you got freedom, justice, then you got equality. You know, so just being God, you know, having a name or a title, or whatever, is one thing. You know, you understand, so a law is a champion without opponents. You know, anybody who's a champion, they got a belt, that means what? They work their way to get to that.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. That's real, though.
Law being the law being the God, you know, right. Seeing her everywhere, he's self-created. He put himself into, brought himself into existence and show and prove himself as the true and living.
Right.
And true and living only means being true to yourself and living out who you are. That's all that really means.
Word. That real talk, God, because, like, even whenever I first got knowledge, right, like, I was, like, me getting rid of my, like, old ways, like, certain savage ways, like, it was a process. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It didn't happen overnight. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And like you said, like, you know, like when you get that belt, it's because like there was shit you had to do to get that belt. You know what I'm saying? Just like a boxer, right. like you know, Floyd Mayweather, one of the greatest. You know what I'm saying? We see him winning all the fights, but you know, the training camps, you know what I'm saying? That he you know, showing his blood, sweat, and tears in, and his discipline, you know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
Like that's what it is. You know what I mean? And so like, that's one of the beautiful things about our nation is the fact that responsibility is going to rely on self. You know what I mean? It's on self, self-savior. We're not waiting on the next person to save us. Now, I don't think that means that it's not good for us to come together. You know what I'm saying? But at the same right. time, the ultimate responsibility is on self to make things right. Is that
right? You know, one thing I was taught is that God is a group reality seen through individual eyes. You know what I'm saying? You know, you have to think. You think on your personal level or your individual level because you got to take care of yourself. You see right. what I'm saying? So then, once you take care of yourself, get yourself together. You know, it's about unification of all people. You have to come amongst the people and make sure they get what you got. You see right. what I'm saying? Right. And make sure everybody else is taken care of as well. Not saying I go out here and just throw a whole bunch of money around the people or whatever, yeah. but check it on your brother, check it on your sister. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Your physical blood family. Make sure your mother's okay, your father's all right.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? If you got to share a jewel with somebody to know so they can be able to grow and develop with that jewel and keep it amongst themselves, that's what you got to do. You know? And then because it's the 12 jewels, and knowledge and understanding, freedom, justice, and equality, food comes to the shelter, love, peace, and happiness. You want to talk about doing the duty of a civilized person, you know, and we know that in 120, it is a knowledgeable degree in the 1 to 40, it isn't really mentioned teaching 120.
Right.
The duty of a civilized person. You know, right. that comes to somebody who actually wants to learn the culture.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? But as far as like the people in general, with the black, brown, you know, why you got to do to all people, all human families, and all those elements in there, you teach to those people in some shape, form, or fashion, whether man, woman, or child.
Word is bond, God. Word is gone. Bond, I appreciate your understanding, you know, making that crystal clear for the people, you know what I'm saying? And for those that are viewing who, so first off, you know, like, we have lessons called, you know, we call 120, and we also have Supreme Mathematics and Supreme Alphabet, right? And for those watching who don't know what Supreme Mathematics and Supreme Alphabet are, can you build on, like, what they are and how they're useful in the everyday life of a 5%?
Well, for starters, Supreme Mathematics, you know, it helps understand our relationship to the universe. You know, it's the law and order of the universe. You know, and it's 10 principles, 1 through 9 and 0, and each one has a principle that we adhere to and that we you know, function on. 1 being knowledge, 2 being wisdom, 3 being understanding, 4 is culture, 5 is power, 6 is equality, 7 is God, 8 is build or destroy, 9 is born, and 0 is cipher. And you go from taking from knowledge to born at a cipher, right? You know, and just everything that we do, all people activities, you know what I'm saying, that we do, you know, is governed by that. You know, even if some, even if you don't know anything about supreme mathematics or the law or the universe as a whole, you're functioning under mathematics. You see what I'm saying? Because every day you wake up and you make a choice. Yeah. Do you want to eat breakfast first or do you want to take a shower first? Right. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's first things first, last things last. You know, it's an order to things. Mm. You see what I'm saying? Law and order. You know what you have to do is standards, pretty much. It's principles and values as far as supreme mathematics go. So the alphabet is technically the same thing. You know, it's 26 letters in the alphabet, obviously. And you go from a law to zigzag zig, you know what I'm saying? You know, A to Z. And each one is accompanied by supreme mathematics. Knowledge being one, which is A, a law. You know, wisdom being two, which is B, be or born. You know, understanding being three, which is C, as an S-E-E, C. With, you know, so we're not just a physical eyes, with the third eye, the mind. Right. You know, and so on and so forth. You know, so, and that is, you know, with some, for a lot of us, you know, we mentioned that supreme alphabets is the language that we speak amongst each other as a 5%. You see what I'm saying? We don't speak the language amongst 85 because they're not going to understand that language.
Right.
When I say 85, I mean the people who don't have this knowledge.
Right.
You see, who are you know, still maybe dealing with a religious aspect of life or whatnot. You see, so we deal with the culture, which is science-based. So everything is science-based. Supreme mathematics and supreme alphabet is both science-based. Because everything we deal with is governed by law and order at the end of the day. So I fast and build that with, you know, understanding and understood.
Most definitely, God. And just to add on is, you know, that's what got me into studying science, right? Is to be, you know, like whenever you, like you, like you mentioned, like the law and order within supreme mathematics, you know, the science of taking something from knowledge to born. And then, and you see, you see that the universe is expressed itself and is understood through mathematics. You know what I'm saying? And it just made, like, you know, like whenever you was in school, you know what I'm saying? Like the way they might explain certain scientific concepts, right? They didn't relate it to us. So we were interested. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But whenever you know the science of the original man, you can relate all of it back to self. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know, you sparked something. You know what I'm saying? And so, like, that's what, that's one of the things that just supreme mathematics has helped me with, is just, you know, starting my love for science. You know what I'm saying? Because, like you said, it's literally the same thing. And with you being, you being from Virginia, can you tell us just about, you know, how the cipher is there, a little bit of the history, you know what I'm saying, the gods and earths in Virginia?
Well, just since I've been around, you know, I'm gonna speak from when I came around, because I could speak on prior to that, though I wasn't necessarily there from the actual beginning days of the God Cities cipher, which is where I'm at. And for those who don't know, God Cities is referring to the Seven Cities area of Virginia, which is the southeastern part of Virginia. And that's seven, like you got New York at the five boroughs, you got the seven cities. You know, we have Virginia Beach, Norfolk, which is where we hold our parliaments at, Chesapeake, which is where I rest at right now, Portsmouth, Newport News, Hampton, and Suffolk. You know, so that's seven cities, that's the God Cities. And I got 97 and 98, and I met a few guards in between that time to 98 and 2000. I met some few guards around that time, but you know, my journey was a whole lot different. I actually came back around 2009, 2010. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? So, and that's a long story I can mention some other time, but when I came around, it was a nice plethora of guards and earths out here. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? And you know, we have our high tides, low tides, and whatever, you know, some fall off, some stay around, some, you know, decide to take on other journeys instead. You know, it still claims supreme mathematics, but you know, they decide to go elsewhere, you know what I mean, for whatever reason. At the end of the day, you know, I know for someone like me and the ones that still around, we hold fast to the culture, we still make manifest our existence to one another, as in we call one another, we build, we still go to parliament, we still, you know, a whole family days. You see what I'm saying? We still make sure that, you know, teaching is taking place in some shape, form, or fashion. We make sure our responsibilities are taken care of as men. You know, it's definitely like, just like pretty much with any other cipher, God, it's like high tides and low tides, to be honest with you. You know what I'm saying? So right now it's a sort of a low tide, but you know, there was a point in time where when you come to a parliament in God cities, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? It will be pretty packed.
Wow.
Right. You know what I'm saying? It'll be pretty packed, you know, yeah. And it's like, you know, it's a beautiful thing when your family come together.
Yeah,
it's a beautiful thing. That's one thing that's attracting me to the culture was the familyhood, the family, yeah. you know what I'm saying? You know, so, you know, it's actually, as far as Victor Law goes, you know, we got Rich Mind Cypher, you know, that's like our family over there in Richmond.
That's a different part of Virginia, right?
Right, that's the actual capital of Virginia.
Okay.
That's like right in the middle.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know, they got maybe like, I want to say an hour or two away from DC maybe.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And we're like an hour and a half maybe away from them.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
You touched on something I kind of wanted to speak on real quick, God, and mm-hmm. you know how you use the word manifest, right? And a lot, and so like you have these new ages now who they talk about like manifesting something just out of thin air, you know what I'm saying, just by thoughts. And I just kind of wanted to set the record straight, like whenever you are building, you know what I'm saying, and we build and we talking about manifesting something, we talking about taking it from the thought and making it a physical reality by putting in work, you know what I'm saying? Like,
sure,
I just wanted to make knowledge born on that, because I know a lot of people hear that word and they think of like what the new ages have done to it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's turning something kind of spooky now.
Yeah,
you know,
it is.
You actually manifesting, of course, is another way of saying born.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Bringing something to existence. You know, when I say manifesting our existence, one another, meaning that we actually going from not being seen to being seen. You
right.
see what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, and it's a thought in the mind, like you said, thoughts being manifested into a reality, into something tangible.
Right. And we know that take work. It's not going to come from just thinking it. You know what I'm saying? That's the first step. That's the knowledge. And like, that's just an example for people who aren't familiar with Supreme Mathematics. That's an example of the ability to take something through the math. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Me and you, we have built on before about offline, about, you know, celebrity activism. And you know, I think we both have some strong opinions on it. I for one am critical of it, because I feel like, you know, people who may be well intentioned in the beginning, right? Once they get a little fame and a check, possibly, you know, that you don't know what their intention is moving forward after that. It seems like they begin to chase fame and celebrity mm-hmm. status more than they do, you know, just, I guess, more than the activism part. You know what I'm saying? What's your thoughts on celebrity activism?
Well, it's just that. It's celebrity mm-hmm. activism.
Right.
Like, we got to look at the word celebrity, you know, right. celebratory, celebration. You see what I'm saying? It's like what they're, like, anybody right now you name, whether it's an athlete, artist, actor, or actress, anybody who's in this type of form of entertainment whatsoever, is a celebrity on some level. But the A-list, B-list, C-list, whatever, they're celebrities. Mm-hmm. They're known to a certain diverse group of people, or just people in general, you know what I'm saying, on whatever level.
Mm-hmm.
And they're celebrated because of what they do.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. They do it very well.
Right.
You know, whether they rap, you know, play ball, whatever, and or act or whatever, you know what I'm saying? And they do it very well. They win Oscars, they win Grammys, they win, you know, trophies and all that.
Mm-hmm.
They're seeking attention for what they do.
Mm-hmm.
Now, on one level, it's cool to seek attention. You want people to pay attention to you so you can be able to, you know, prolong your career.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? You know, but then it gets to a point where you start to devalue certain things along in your career, because you know people gonna buy it anyway, because hey, I'm a celebrity, I'm gonna do whatever I do. I already am established.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever I put out there, they're gonna just do whatever they do just to make me more celebrated. You're gonna buy my music, gonna go to the movies and see whatever, you know what I'm saying, and come out disappointed because it's like, dang, I expected something like it was when we first came out.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? I expected an Oscar performance, I expected a classic album, and it's just lackluster.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Now, add activist to that, God. It's like, whoa, hold on. So now we got activists seeking attention on a whole nother level now. Because it's like, in the beginning, it's like, because the question is, what do they value exactly? See what I'm saying?
Right.
When they become celebrity activists, you know what I'm saying? That basically means that they're looking to be celebrated. Let's name Breonna Taylor. Let's name Ahmaud Arbery. Let's name George Floyd. Let's say these names out there as shock value,
right?
In a way, right?
Right.
Just to get people's attention. So therefore, that way, I could be celebrated for even name dropping.
Right.
You damn. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Once I name drop, now I got the attention, and now can't nobody say I'm not doing it for the community because, hey, I said Tamir Rice's name. I said Trayvon Martin's name. I'm pumping my fist in the air and I'm on the front lines in the street with a bullhorn talking this talk. I'm at the Grammys talking this talk. And it's like, okay, but it's justice being served though.
Right, right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right. Damn, powerful breakdown, God. And like, yeah, like you said, like it's justice being served. And at what point does it become, like you know, and it's to rewind it back real quick, like you mentioned, like how they'll mention Breonna Taylor and you know, Tamir Rice, and the wild part about it is, you know, the mothers of these people who have been brothers and sisters who have been assassinated by
children,
the police, they're saying they're not receiving anything for all of the name dropping that these organizations and celebrity activists are doing. And so like you mentioned, yeah, are they bringing light to what's going on, or are they bringing light to themselves? You know what I'm saying?
Right. You know, it's something in the water, you know, because let's keep it real, God. In more ways than one, you have the system of oppression that we're under, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And in more ways than one, they try to make things less or more than what it is that we see on face value.
Right.
See what I'm saying?
Right.
We know there's an agenda. So we may not be able to see the actual people behind closed doors planning it. The results show that it is actually taking place.
Mm-hmm.
When you have someone like Tamika Mallory,
right?
Okay, you have someone like her who makes it look like she's for the people,
right? Right.
You see what I'm saying? Though her first target is women.
Mm.
You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like she's targeting women. Mm-hmm. More so than anything, she's more like, you know, about the women empowerment,
right?
And not black empowerment. Black right. empowerment comes second, women right. empowerment comes first for her,
right?
You see
right.
what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so it's like,
what are your thoughts on that, God? As for because you know, there are a lot, and I'm not saying, and like, you know, I'm not saying that women don't have it, like, especially sisters have it tough out here, and I don't think that's what you're saying either. But what do you right. think? What do you think it means? Like for like to put like, so do you think if a black woman puts issues or accepts feminist thought or feminism over you know, her fight is a feminist fight over the fight for freedom, justice, equality of original people, do you see an issue with that?
Yes, there's definitely an issue because they're being easily in the wrong direction.
Mm.
You see, like I said, it's something in the water where we're coming out dealing with the system of oppression, or how we call it 10%, pretty much. You know, the agenda is to basically take the original man off the planet.
Right.
So the way to do that is to put the woman in the front.
Mm.
You see what I'm saying? Mm. And make them think that their struggle is a lot more important than the struggle of family.
Mm.
Man, woman, and child.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? we see how black men are in prison the most. They're dead. A lot of them die the most. I'm saying mm-hmm. that older age, young age, whatever. I'm saying we're dead or in jail, or out of us been on that on the DL. You see mm-hmm. what I'm saying? Through agenda. Whereas, so therefore, the woman's like, well, since I don't have no backbone here through the man, mm-hmm. therefore, I have no children, and I don't want children, because if I get children, it'll get in front of my career. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I have to make the most out of what is done, what I need to do for me, right. And me only. It's about me. You know what I'm saying? But the moment something goes down, something happens, who do they run to?
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. They run, come back, run back to us.
Right.
But we're not there anymore.
Right.
So it's like, it's a plan from the jump. And so therefore they think feminism, but not thinking about the actual empowerment of the black, unified black family.
Yeah. You know, that's powerful, God, because that's really where our power is in a unified black family.
Yes.
Yeah, I want to see, you know, freedom, justice, equality for original people, regardless to whom or what, but that starts with the black family. Like, and I think, just adding on to what you said, like, that's not something that's talked about much whenever we, you know, see these activists speaking on, issues within the community. They don't speak on the, you know, diabolical plan to separate the black man from woman. Sometimes they just kind of run with their separation. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they don't know where it's coming from. And a lot of times they don't really care.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? It's already, as long as it's being pandered to and taken care of by the system in some way, it's like, well, shoot, as long as I'm getting my end of it, I'm just going to keep it moving.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? So, you know.
That's real. I want to since we were, you know, somewhat building on hip hop as well, and you were, part of your path to getting knowledge yourself was being introduced to certain concepts through music, right? And that music was on the mainstream, you know what I'm saying? You didn't have to go to the underground necessarily to find it, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You might have had to have somebody help you to understand what they were saying, but the music was always there. Now it's a little bit different as far as what's on the mainstream, right? And like when I was building with you earlier, I was talking about, you know, even the music that is so-called, like, you know, has a certain message to it. To me, it don't really compare to things that were on the, like, you know, Public Enemy during the Fight the Power days, and mm-hmm. even with Wu and Nas, like in their golden era days, mm-hmm. you know, Brand Nubian, Lakim Shabazz, Killer Priest, like when that stuff was on the mainstream, we was being hit with concepts that was elevating our mind. Now, even if they do talk about something, it seemed like it's cliche, and they just put that out there because they knew it would get a little bit of support. What's your thoughts on on how, you know, from the era of, you know, Fight the Power, and how that kind of music was really galvanizing the people. We had brothers and sisters wearing X hats and all that kind of stuff, to, you know, some of the stuff now where you don't really feel it as much.
Yeah, well, the thing about it, that during that time frame, it was, I mean, either way, honestly, it's a need for it, regardless if it's back then or nowadays.
Yeah.
But at that time, I mean, you had, Reaganomics had hit pretty hard, and the crack era came in '84.
Mm-hmm.
Right after that, you have the Bush era.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? And during that time frame, you mentioned Public Enemy, Fight the Power. That was a song to the soundtrack, Do the Right Thing.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Which is about revolution.
Right.
You know what I mean? It's all about something that's very revolutionary. And they were talking about fighting the power. You see what I'm saying? Fighting the powers that be.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas nowadays, it's like, align yourself with the power.
Right.
You see exactly. What I'm saying?
Right.
You know, and even if you're aligning yourself with the power, you can say a little bit here and there about the power. I hate to fight a little bit, but don't go too far.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Because the little bit that you say, they know that it's not going to be sincere. It's just something you're saying just to get people's attention. Mm-hmm. You turn around and do something that's totally opposite of what you said.
Right. Exactly.
You see what I'm saying? You know, so back then it was a lot more of a need for it, you know, because it was hip hop was actually being the voice of the voices at that time.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? It was still young in its days.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, when you're young and you strive to get known like that, become known like that, you're going to pinpoint things that's going on around you, reality,
yeah,
parts of,
right,
you know, a reality, and make not as born or let people know that this is what's going on in our community.
Mm-hmm.
This is what we need to do to take care of it, so we can all live in unison and be able to thrive as a people.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? So, you know, nowadays it's like I said, it's just do whatever it takes to get the bag.
Right. Yeah.
And if it's being conscious, do it. You don't have to get the bag, just do it.
Right. No, you're right. I seen an article. It was written by some like UK site across the water. But they were like, they were talking about how hip hop has become the face of capitalism, right? Like what MC come out and like, if you look at it, like every MC that come out gotta tell you that, you know, he was rich before he came out, right? Like, that's not the reality of original people in our communities. You know what I'm saying? Like, whether you was, even if you was hustling, doesn't necessarily mean that you wasn't a kingpin. You know what I'm saying? And so, like, this narrative that you got to have the Benz and the chain before you got on, you know, I feel like is something that needs to be addressed in hip hop, because I've been seeing instances. I saw two stories. One was this young brother in Chicago who wanted to be a rapper, and he was like 19, 20 or something, right? His mother had a successful beauty salon. And, you know, she was taking good care of him. And, you know, she was a Black business owner and doing things for the community. She was well-loved and respected in the community. Well, he wanted to be a rapper so bad, but felt like, you know, brainwashed to feel like a lot of these other rappers that you got to play the part on Instagram and all of that shit, right? Before, and like, fuck the music. Like, you got to play the part, right? So he had his mother killed by his homeboys. Took the insurance money that, you know what I'm saying, she left him, which was over like $1 million or some shit like that. And then got on Instagram and, you know, started doing the whole rapper shit, putting the money to the ear, just the whole fake rapper thing, right? And then there's another, this brother in Maryland I just read about. He had a good job, and he stole the company credit card, and like ran over like 4 years, ran up $1 million in shit to make him look like a rapper to promote his music, right? And so this is goofy shit, but you see how like powerful that imagery is to so like our lessons say that 85% are easily led in the wrong direction, right? That shit is an example of a weak mind being led in the wrong direction, man. And it's just like, the imagery is crazy. Like, what's your thoughts on the whole notion, you know, like just the imagery that they're putting out for MCs where you got to be rich before you come out, or you got to be the dope dealer before you come out. Like, they all got to fit this same narrative, man. Like, in actuality, some of us worked jobs, some of us went to college, some of us didn't, some of us was in the streets, some of us wasn't. Like, what's your thought on it?
Yeah. Well, first off, in regards to that situation with brother in Chicago, got his brother killed.
Yeah.
I mean, that's desperation like no other. Like you that desperate for attention and money and fame, you actually have your own mother killed.
Yeah, crazy shit, dog.
I'm saying that's That's savagery. That's devilish, man.
Yeah.
Off the rip right there. Like, you, like, easily in the wrong direction. And it's like being lost beyond reach. There's no coming back from that.
Yeah.
You can't even teach a brother like that.
Right, right, right.
You see what I'm saying? You know, and then the brother in Maryland running up a credit card, $1 million or whatever. I mean, that's just clear stupidity.
Yeah.
You know, it's stupid on both ends, but it's like, you know, my thoughts on all of that, God, is, it's simply put, it's that easy in the wrong direction. The thing about it is that it's so in depth that these individuals are striving to get to a point in life.
Yeah.
You know, that they say, you know, I gotta have this life already set for me to get this life where it confirms how I'm already living. It's like, if I'm living like this already, you see what I'm saying? Because it's like, the struggle don't matter no more.
Right, right, right.
So today's alphabet, for those who, also for those who don't know, and our supreme alphabet is the letter L, love, hell, or right.
Right.
That's coincided as the 12th alphabet, which is regards to these mathematics being knowledge and wisdom, okay? If you love yourself enough, you go through that hell to come out right. In order to really love yourself, you have to know yourself. In order to know yourself, you have to love yourself.
Mm.
And all of that, you go through hell. Because with the knowledge of self, you know, I'm going to set myself in heaven at once. That's what the NOI say.
Yeah.
Set yourself in heaven at once.
Right.
That once or that one, that's the one. That's the knowledge. In your mind, you have to know yourself in heaven. So therefore, when you go through hell, it's nothing can put you asunder.
Right.
You see the understanding, which is you being right and exact, and what you did, you actually put in the work and went through the struggle to get to where you need to be at. See what I'm saying? Nas, so my favorite lines, God, in Affirmative Action, he says, life's a bitch, but God forbid the bitch divorce me. I'll be friendly with ice, so hellfire can't scorch me.
Right.
When he said that, it resonated with me so much about knowledge and understanding, love, hurt, or right, because the ice ain't necessarily the platinum and gold that he's talking about.
Right.
It's like, in my mind,
right,
let me flood myself with ice in my mind, so therefore when I go through hell, it won't scorch me.
Right. Wow.
You see what I'm saying?
Right, right, right.
So it's like these brothers in Chicago, and Maryland, and all those like them are not loving themselves enough to say, you know what? Nah, keep that. I'm going to start from the bottom and work my way up.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? And this is where manhood ain't manhood no more. Therefore, like I said earlier in the beginning of this interview of the show, where God only mean man. If you're not being a man, you're not going to be God. Every man ain't going to know to understand or know understand the importance of responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
So there you have it. You're going to have individuals killing their mama, burning up credit cards, and do all kinds like devilish, stealing, terrorized, and massive individual man, which is, you know, it's we all know that that's just the science of, you know, making themselves less than who they are.
Yeah.
Pretty much. Weak and wicked.
Yeah, and I think that's also an example of how you said hip hop started off as a voice of the people, right? Well, that ain't the voice of the people being every black man and woman being, you know, extremely rich and not having to deal with the systematic oppression that we know exists in America, right? Like that ain't real. You know what I'm saying? And it's crazy that you know, impressionable minds are at stake, you know, and like you said, like brothers, some brothers and sisters that's that far gone, you know what I'm saying? That's why the father said, you know, teach the babies, right? Because you know, I just feel like we're coming to a point in time where not just hip hop, but everything damn near that we see on TV or hear on mainstream radio. Because when I say mainstream radio, I do know and understand that there are brothers and sisters on the underground that are holding it down and, you know what I'm saying, and doing what needs to be done. But the shit that they push out that's easily accessible, all that shit just seems wrong. You know what I'm saying? Like, as far as what it's doing to minds that don't know any better. You know what I'm saying?
Indeed so, God. You know, so it's a struggle that's it's a lost struggle.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? You know, it's a lost struggle. So, you know, it takes one to really have the humility and the intelligence to really find that struggle and be able to go through it to get to it. That's time.
Yeah. Yeah, but hey, you know, when you know, and like you said, that's the science of being a man. And I was building with somebody today, you know, like it's like the feeling that you get from having a thought in your mind and then bringing it to a reality, and you see that become successful and you see it work. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no better feeling than that. Like there ain't no shortcuts in this life. You know what I'm saying? There's no shortcut within supreme mathematics. There ain't no shortcuts in the laws of physics. There ain't no right. shortcuts, you know what I'm saying, to create the reality that you want for yourself. You know what I'm saying? And you know, while we on hip hop, I wanted to ask you this, God, do you think that like, you know, the younger generation, like they're aware of things like, you know, saying peace, how we say peace on the record, even cats that do now, like the B-boy stance and the term cypher and all of that, you know, do you think that people really understand that that came from the gods?
Honestly, I don't think so from my experience, because there's been a few people that, like for instance, I came across someone recently who I was the first 5% I ever met.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm breaking down to them, you know, who we are, what we about, what we teach, everything. And, you know, I let them know that it's a lot of artists in hip hop who are 5%ers.
Right.
I saw naming them, Wu-Tang, Rakim, Big Daddy Kane, you know, AZ. I'm named Busta Rhymes. I'm naming them, like, you know, name dropping, whatever. And they're like, oh, really? I didn't even know that. I said, well, you know, I mean, y'all know about 5% know that. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, and I know that a lot of the terminology that's utilized in hip hop, you know, word is bond, cipher, you know, things of that nature, even, like third eye, and, you know, even when we say this, that, and the third.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Right. Like, stuff like that. That all come from us.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? I said that word is bond actually goes back in the 1930s. You know, I 120 in our lessons, word is bond and center.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Have you never heard that your word shall be bond regardless of what? Yes, my word is bond, and bond means life, and I get my life from a word shall what? Fail.
Wow,
you see what I'm saying? This is Elijah and Forrest speaking to one another.
Right.
1930s, you see what I'm saying? So I'm like, yo, so word is bond and been around since before our grandparents was born.
Right.
You see
right.
what I'm saying?
Right.
You know, so when and this is somebody who's around my age. This is a sister.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? You know, and then now you're talking about as far as the younger generation. If she didn't know, if she's my age,
no, they don't.
Honestly, they ain't gonna really know.
Yeah, yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And again, I hate to say it, God, but you honestly probably ain't gonna care. Because right. the way the woke movement is right now, mm-hmm. anything is woke.
Yeah,
anything is woke. And if it's the woke labels on it, it's just mm-hmm. something to be, it's cool right now.
Mm-hmm.
Not something to really, really know about and be rooted in.
What you think the difference is? Saying? What you think the difference is from being woke and having knowledge yourself?
Well, remember, God, we present knowledge yourself. We had an enlightener.
Mm-hmm.
And in fact, enlightener is our anthem in the nation. The
right.
enlightener. We enlighten people.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? During that time, we was like, you know, waking people up. That's what we were saying. We waking people up.
Right.
You know? And it was a sincerity in it. It was actual movement. It was actually coming together and building with our people and making knowledge known to the people about who we are and learning history, science, mathematics, and art, all kinds of things, and learning about not only ourselves, but other people as well.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? And their cultures. And just learning about how we the fathers and mothers of civilization. Mm-hmm. You know, how we the gods of the universe and the black women the queens of the universe. You see what mm-hmm. I'm saying? You know, and we're learning these things and actually putting in work in the streets or whatever, or just know us who all who is putting in work in the streets, you know, in some kind of way, whether it's the 5% nation, the Nation of Islam, the Moorish Science Temple, the Nubians, or you know, any Zulu Nation, anybody of that fabric,
right?
So-called conscious community, that school of thought. Was built in some manner, whether it was amongst themselves or amongst other people.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Where nowadays, woke is just knowing that, you know, COVID-19 is a pandemic.
Yeah.
That's right. All you need to know.
Word.
Just knowing that, you know, say just knowing that, you know, oh, Bush and Obama is related.
Right.
Like, oh, snap, you find something online. These things you find online, right. You know, some of it may be true, but no real research is being done to make sure that it is actual fact.
That's real, and they'll run with it and treat it as if it is actual fact. I want to just let you know, God, I definitely appreciate you for coming on. You know what I'm saying? It's a powerful bill for brothers that and sisters that want to, you know, find you on social media. Can you let everybody know how to follow you?
Well, yeah, I got Instagram and a Facebook. Instagram is Supreme_Justice_. You know, Supreme, SUPREME _ Justice, JUSTICE _. Facebook is my honorable name, or my government name is J. Arrington II. You know what I mean? Just look that up, and there I am. You see me.
No doubt, God. I definitely appreciate you for coming on, God.
Okay. Peace indeed, God. So, till next time, Almighty.
Yeah, for sure. Peace to the God.
Peace.